Nothing scares people more than a sequel.
After everything we've seen, there isn't much that rattles either of us anymore. But this one still haunts me. Does it feel like the voice is coming from inside you?
More like it's coming from behind me.
So hey guys, so this is the second review I'm doing for my new channel here. And this one is going to be The Conjuring 2. This is the new film from James Wan, director of Saw, Insidious, and of course the last Conjuring movie, and several of the Fast and the Furious movies, which apparently he actually turned down what is quote unquote a life-changing amount of money to do this latest one because he just really wanted to do a horror movie. So respect to James Wan for that one. But anyways, going into this movie, this is the latest in the saga of the Warren family, which is Ed and Lorraine, played by Patrick Wilson and Vera Farmiga, based on the real Warren family of quote-unquote paranormal investigators, depending on your level of belief of that. But yeah, I just saw this movie and I gotta say I'm impressed once again. The Conjuring was probably the most surprising horror movie, I think, in terms of what I went in expecting to what I got. With the first one just blew me away from the opening title crawl, which they do advance even more in this movie. It's slightly less creepy after already seeing it the first time, but the title crawl is still very long and very ominous as it starts off with a very scary music, which persists throughout the movie to mostly good effect. Now, the youngest daughter, played by Madison Wolf, which is Janet, definitely steals the show in terms of the kid actors and kind of the non-Warren group of this movie. And she plays the kind of possessed at times, kind of being attacked by the demon child. And she really just, as with the last movie I watched, The Nice Guys, kind of takes like a third lead role in this movie and really steals the show, both in her kind of possession acting capabilities and how she acts with the Warrens throughout the movie. Looking to some other scenes, there's a lot of really interesting scenes with the demons in this movie, which tend to be the standout scenes with the various demons throughout this film. One of which being the opening scene of this movie, which is the actually not a demon scene, but a haunting scene, which is the scene where they recreate the Amityville horror, and or they investigate the Amityville horror, and Vera Farmiga's character kind of goes in and relives the experience of the family's murder to understand what's going on. And just the whole sequence is very interesting. She kind of like takes the place of the murder in this scene, and it's very powerful imagery and really shocks you, especially going down to when the demon kind of comes into the scene. But once again, like the first movie, the opening sequence of this movie kind of detached from the rest of the movie, but it's just a really cool kind of scary scene to set the tone for the movie. And I hope that they keep this theme of kind of disembodied, if you want to put it that way, opening sequences to just set the tone for the movie. I think they're like almost like you could watch that and be like, that would be a great movie in its own right. And it always sets the tone really well, like they did with Annabelle in the first movie. Now, the last cool part of the movie, this is one of the ones that really got me and actually amped up the scares. This is going to be spoilers, just a heads up, so definitely skip this part. If you hear this part, it will kind of ruin a bit of the movie. But the name of the demon actually ends up showing up earlier on in the movie in an interesting way, where the name of the demon is really important to them fighting at the end of the movie. And if you actually pay attention earlier on in the movie, throughout the Warren's house, there's this weird name, and I actually noticed it and wondered what kind of name is Valak and why is it throughout the house. And I just thought it was the creepiest sort of foreshadowing and showing that the Warrens were being haunted throughout the movie from the start. So going to the only real negatives of the movie, I will say the amount of creepy camera work was a little bit lacking in this one compared to the first one. There are a lot less of the super creepy zooms that they had in the first movie that were like terrifying, even if they were just zooming in on like almost nothing in the first movie that really creeped me out. We're a little bit lacking this time, but nonetheless, there's lots of cool camera work in this one. I just thought it was, you know, almost just random things were missing in that respect. Looking to other things that kind of pulled it down a little bit. There's a couple jokes throughout the movie, or almost kind of like dry humor throughout the movie, with a couple like smoking jokes about the mom smoking and telling her kids, why are you smoking? That happens multiple times too, so it's not even just breaking the tone, but it also kind of just seems like a bad joke once you said it once or twice. Just little things like that kind of break the tone. And there's this, going to the other part, there's a couple musical interludes throughout the movie. First off, when they introduce London into the story, kind of they use like a London Calling as the intro to this whole sequence, and they don't just go right to like footage. They do like a weird montage of what was happening in the era, and it just seems totally out of place, especially considering it's not even the intro to the movie. After they set this horror tone, they kind of bring you into this fun period, 70s period thing, and then they drop you back into the horror pretty much soon after that. And it just seemed very weird, and the song goes on for a good minute and a half, kind of leaving you wondering what's going on here, and really taking the horror aspect out. And lastly, and the only other thing, I think the middle of the movie drags a little bit. They kind of just go on this, like, is the ghost real, is the ghost not real? And this actually takes up the bulk of the movie, you know, and knowing kind of from the audience perspective, you're aware that this is real and this like Conjuring, and you kind of just know what's going on here. So in that respect, it kind of holds the movie from moving for a while, which I think is my only real big qualm with the movie, that puts it kind of mixed with the first movie. I'm not sure which one I would say I actually prefer based on this one. So, going to wrap it up, The Conjuring is probably a parable sequel. It's pretty much on par with the original movie. I think the original movie might just sneak a little bit ahead for me. Definitely gonna be in my like top five movies for the year right now. I don't know what to say other than that. Definitely one of the cooler horror movies I've seen this year, The Conjuring, and James Wan stuff's always pretty interesting. Generally, most of the movie's good. The cast is good, especially the kids. The Warrens are mostly good. I'd say the only real problem with the movie is it drags a little bit in the middle, and like there's a couple musical things that take the tone a little bit for a second, but other than that, it's quite good. I'm gonna say probably an 8 for this movie. You know, nothing super exceptional, not like a It Follows or something like that, or a Goodnight Mommy of 2015, but definitely, I guess in terms of horror movies, this is one of the better ones that still pack a couple jump scares for people. I think 8 out of 10 is what you're gonna get for this one, and I will see you on the flip side.